and might be you are writing wrong tag in that. But in this software, whenever you will write HTML tag, it will give you the list as well. What are the other tags are available in this? And many more functionalities are there. No need to go to that folder, open that page manually. You can run your page directly from this software.
It's coming up differently.
Yeah. Then go to view. Click on Solution Explorer. First one. View solution. You are having this window?
Yeah, I'm having it, but in the middle it's three.
It's okay.
It's the same.
It's okay. You done? Okay, now after that, this is your folder name, website 2. Right click on that. Right click on that folder. And new item. Right click on your folder name, website 2, and whatever you are having. Add new item. In this, you have to select this HTML page. You can give a different name to your HTML page. Like this is my, I forgot HTML. And add. Last we have discussed hyperlink. Now, in this folder, in Solution Explorer, you are having one page, hyper.html. If you want to add one more page, you have to follow the same. Right click, add new item, another page, give a page name. New, add. Okay, so there are two pages. This is hyper.html, this is new.html. Fine, all of you please add these two pages. You should have at least two pages. You have to follow the same. In Solution Explorer, right click on your folder name, new.
I have to give same name?
No. Not same name. You have to give different name to your FD file. Okay? You have to add at least two pages. I am having two pages. New.html and hyper.html. Now, on that day we have discussed one tag called A. See, whenever you will write like this, you will be having list of tags. So I want a tag which page I have to I want to open new dot html. So I can write anything, click here to open new page. It's easy?
Yes.
Easy to use? Better than Notepad?
Yes.
Done? Okay. After adding this thing, go to your second page. Go to your second page and add the same tag. Content so that you can see the output easily. What you can do, you can contain this tag into H1. Okay, and this tag here. Okay, same thing you have to do with another page. To see the output, you can see this green icon here. This green icon you can see in your menu bar, okay? So you can directly click here to see the output. Done into last session. Now, after that, close your browser. Okay. Now, our today's topic is CSS. So let's talk about what is CSS actually.
Cascading style sheet.
Cascading style sheet. Fine. So today we are going to use this style sheet into our application, into to our pages. Cascading star sheet. Okay? In this sheet, we'll be having so many things available so that I can make my page more attractive, or you can say colorful or more beautiful. Okay? So I have to use this CSS in that. Now first of all, there are three types of CSS available. Internal CSS, external CSS, and inline CSS. CSS, we need one tag called style tag. This is for internal. This thing for internal only, okay? Now for external. inline CSS first of all. How to use inline CSS? Okay. So, as you know, we have to use style tag for inline CSS. Where? In tag itself. So let's suppose I am having this tag, h tag. I am having this h tag, and I want to give a style to this. Fine. Generally, we use this h tag like this. This is a heading 1. Okay. Whenever you will see the output for this, it always comes like this. But I want to give a different style to my tab, H1. So what I will do, I will write H1, okay, H1, in this I will write style. What style I want to give? I want to give color. Which color? I want to give this color. What else I want to give? I want to give another property, font. Okay, so these two properties I want to give. So this is your inline style. This is your inline CSS. So now if I will write same thing, heading 1, how it will be there? So I have defined one style into this. This is a simple one. The output for this simple one is this. If you want to add some style, you have to add your style like this. Okay? Now, to use these property, you have to colon. You have to use colon here, not equal to. Color, colon, color code. Or you can directly write color name. You can directly write color name. Okay? Font family means font type. Which font type I want? Fine. That you have to select from that list. That's it. Okay. So like this, we are having so many properties available into CSS. Okay. So this is all about your inline CSS. This is all about your inline CSS. Let's suppose I want to give background color as well. So what I will write, I will separate each property with the help of semicolon. So this is one property, this is second property, after that I can write fourth one. So I want to give background color. So this is a background color. Which color I want to give? I want to give black. Okay? Now, if I will save this one, so this is for background color. So now my output is this.
Saan binubuksan? Saan pinapakita? Wala na yung Chrome. Wala na yung Chrome. Sa taas. Ay, paano ako makita?
Can you see this item? Click here.
Ay, ito. Stop. Saan? Stop.
You can see this one again. Okay. Green. Inline CSS. You can use this inline CSS with any tag. I want to use T tag. In P tag again, I will use style. Fine. Again, I can give color. Which color I want? I want blue color. Okay. Then for this paragraph, what will be the font size? So font size will be larger. Okay, so like this I can give properties. So if I will write, this is my HTML page. Okay, if I'll show you the output for this, see. Okay, if I want to give a extra large size, so what I will write, extra large. So okay, so this inline property, inline CSS, you can use with any tag. Any tag. Fine? We have discussed so many tags till now. So you can use this CSS with any tag. Is it clear? This is all about inline. Now try this one. Use this inline style sheet into your another page here. In second page, try this inline CSS again. Then we will discuss about internal. I got your fees notice. You have to pay your fee. Okay, so I'll give you the slips today. So they have mentioned a date so that you have to complete that. Okay, so I'll give it to you today. Fees next installment. For internal CSS, as you know, we have already written here that we have to use style tag into head. So this is my head section. This is my head. So in between, we'll write style tag. Okay? Thank you.
tools when you put something that is inside. It doesn't help.
Fine. After that, now let's suppose again I want to apply some styles on H1. So what I will do, I will write H1. Then curly bracket start and okay. I want to give color. Color red. Background color. Fine. And font family. Okay. So I can save this one. And if I will run this page. Now, what is the benefit to use internal CSS? Now, once you define this, this is a style for H1. This style which you have defined is for H1 tag. Now, wherever you will use this H1 tag, this style automatically apply. H1, heading 1. No need to do anything. Just use H1 tag normally. And when you will see the output, see. Fine. Anywhere you can use you this tag anywhere. H1 my web page. No need to do anything. You have to just define this style once. Automatically it is applying because I have defined H1 and this style. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this style is for only H1. So this is your internal. Let's suppose I want to apply style for P tag. So after this bracket, I will write P tag. Same. Okay, so this style is for B tag, this style is for H1. So if I will use P tag here.
for eight.
What, sir?
Create one internal style for A tag. Like we have defined this for H1 tag and B tag.
Yeah.
You have to write for A tag.
A.
This is called A. Okay. And use some properties.
Any
properties. See which are the properties are available and like that. Click on your website name, folder name,